Hello everyone, Namaste, welcome to Vyasna. I'm Sudhanshu and in today's lecture, we'll be discussing the endocrine system and the effect of yogic practice on endocrine system. There are seven endocrine glands in the body. They pass their secretion directly into the bloodstream without the help of ducts. Hence, they are called ductless gland. These glands are the pituitary gland, the thyroid gland, the parathyroid gland, the adrenal gland, the islets of Langerhans in the pancreas, the pineal gland, and the testes and ovaries. So the first one is the pituitary gland. The pituitary gland is an endocrine gland about the size of a pea that sits in a small bony cavity at the base of the brain. It is also known as the master gland. The pituitary gland secretes hormone that stimulate the other endocrine glands. Located at the base of the brain, it is functionally linked to the hypothalamus. The tiny pituitary is divided into two parts, the anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. The anterior lobe regulates the activity of thyroid, adrenals, and reproductive glands. The posterior lobe releases antidiuretic hormones, which helps control the balance of water in the body. The pituitary glands helps control the following body process: in growth, in controlling blood pressure, in some aspects of pregnancy and childbirth, in breast milk production, in sex organ function in both man and woman, in thyroid gland function, and in the conversion of food into energy. The second one is the pineal gland. The pineal body, also called the pineal gland, is located in the middle of the brain. It secretes melatonin, a hormone that may help regulate when you sleep at night and when you wake in the morning. The pineal gland is a small endocrine gland in the brain. Its functions are not yet fully understood. It produces a hormone called melatonin and is located at the center of the brain. The pineal gland is a reddish gray body about the size of a pea. The pineal gland is large in children but shrinks at puberty. It appears to play a major role in sexual development. The third one is the thymus gland. The thymus is an organ located in the upper anterior portion of the chest, underneath the top of the sternum. It has two lobes which generally differ in size and are a soft and pinkish green color. At birth, it is about 5 cm in length, 4 cm in breadth, and about 6 mm in thickness. The organ enlarges during childhood. The thymus plays an important role in the development of the immune system during childhood. And the fourth one is the thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is one of the large endocrine glands in the body. It is a double-lobed structure located in the neck and produces hormones, principally thyroxine and triiodothyronine, which regulate the rate of metabolism and affect the growth and rate of function of many other systems in the body. The hormone calcitonin is also produced and controls calcium blood levels. Iodine is necessary for the production of both hormones. Hypothyroidism, which is overactive thyroid, and hypothyroidism, which is underactive thyroid, are the most common problems of the thyroid gland. The fifth one is the parathyroid gland. The parathyroid gland are the small endocrine gland in the neck, usually located behind the thyroid gland, which produces the parathyroid hormone. In rare cases, the parathyroid glands are located within the thyroid gland. Most often, there are 4 parathyroid glands, but some people have 6 or even 8. The parathyroid gland produces the parathyroid hormone, which regulates the level of calcium in the blood with the help of calcitonin, which is produced in the thyroid and bones. It then stimulates osteochondrocytes to break down bone and release calcium into the blood. Now the sixth one is the adrenal gland. In mammals, the adrenal glands are the triangle-shaped endocrine glands that sits atop the kidney. Their name indicates their position. Anatomically, the adrenal glands are located in the abdomen. In humans, the adrenal glands are found at the level of the 12th thoracic vertebrae and receive their blood supply from the adrenal arteries. An adrenal gland is made up of two parts: the outer region called adrenal cortex, which influence and regulate the salt and water balance in the body, and the inner region called the adrenal medulla, which increase blood pressure and heart rate when the body experiences stress. The adrenal gland work interactively with the hypothalamus and pituitary gland. The last one is the islets of Langerhans in the pancreas. The islets of Langerhans are the region of the pancreas that contain its endocrine cell. The pancreas work as both the exocrine and the endocrine glands. The exocrine portion of the pancreas helps in secretion of digestive juice, and the endocrine part consists of clusters of cells called islets of Langerhans. Now, the effect of yogic practice on the endocrine system. Yoga is the only system where it is possible to consciously reduce glandular secretions. The main aim of asana is to preserve glandular function and maintain optimum energy level. The stimulation also does not exhaust the glandular sections. Standing postures. These poses stimulate the glandular system so that the glands are made to function properly. Inverted poses. In Shirsasana, the pituitary gland and the pineal gland are soaked in blood. This helps maintain their optimum functioning. The thyroid and parathyroid glands are well fed with blood in shoulder stand and halasana due to the chin lock. This massages the gland, improving their blood supply. Thyroid dysfunctions are prevented by these two poses. The adrenal gland is given rest. This conscious rest given to the sympathetic nerve in asana is the mechanism by which recuperation occurs. At the nervous and endocrine system are in harmony, they help affect each other's proper functioning. Age-related atrophy of the cells in the endocrine gland does not affect the practitioners of inverted poses. Forward bends. The hormonal status doesn't fluctuate from the baseline. All endocrine glands are suited by the practice of forward bends. As the mind is kept quiet, the nervous system is resting. This in turn soothes the glandular system. The adrenal glands derive maximum benefits due to the soothing action of these poses. The adrenal glands are profusely innervated with the sympathetic nerve, and if this system is rested, the gland doesn't suffer exhaustion and its cellular contents are preserved. It is interesting that a regular practitioner of yoga feels the lack of energy by omitting forward bends, even for a day. Metabolic activity slows down. This gives rest to the thyroid gland. The entire system recuperates by the regular practice of forward bends. The degeneration of the body slows down as one gets older. Backbending. Through the practice of backbends, the major endocrine glands are stimulated in contrast to forward bend. The effect can be felt very fast. The adrenal, pituitary, pineal, and thyroid gland are stimulated. The ovarian cell, which secretes female hormones, are also stimulated. As the asanas are intensive in nature, the metabolic rate is sped up. The degeneration of these glands do not occur as one grows older. So this is the end of today's topic. Hope you will understand properly from this video. Thank you.